Hello, my dear little students. I hope you are enjoying staying at home with your parents and other family members. So now the study time, and I am going to teach you science chapter 4. The name of the chapter is My Needs. What is the needs? Water. We will discuss about water in this chapter. So open your book, all of you, and chapter 4, page 31. Okay. Chapter 4, page 31. So after reading this chapter, we will come to know about the sources of water, storage of water, uses of water, fun with water, and saving water, how to save water. Today I am going to discuss about two topics. First two topics, that is sources of water in the surroundings and storage of water. So first of all, we should know that all plants and animals and human beings on this earth need water in order to live. Everybody needs water. Every living being needs water. Without of water, it cannot stay alive. Now the question is, from where does we get water? Actually, the rain water is the main source of water on this earth. From where the water comes on this earth? Water comes on this earth due to the rain. If rain falls doesn't occur, the earth will be totally dry. Due to the rain, all oceans, seas, rivers, ponds, lakes, etc. and etc. takes place. That means due to the rainfall, oceans, seas, rivers, ponds, these are growing. So rain is the main source of water. Other sources of water are rivers, ponds, lakes, and seas. These sources are filled up by rainwater. These other sources are filled up with rainwater. Where from water comes in seas, oceans, rivers? Water comes from the rainfall. Water comes into this from the rainfall. Now turn the page, all of you. Next is, some rainwater also seeps into the ground. We dig wells or use hand pumps to take this water from the underground. So due to the some rainfall which seeps into the ground, while it rains, some parts of the rainwater goes under the ground and it remains there. That underground water we can pull up through hand pumps, and that underground water makes wells. So these are the other sources of water, wells and hand pumps. We get water in our houses through taps. We are getting water in our houses through tap. So we are drinking, we are using tap water in our houses. Some other houses you will find in villages, they are using wells water. They have wells in front of their house. In the villages you might have seen mostly. In cities and towns it is very rarely seen, but in villages you can see these wells. So from wells they are getting the water for their household needs. So how we store water? Water is stored at home in bottles, in pots, in buckets, etc. and etc. But large amount of water is stored outside in water tanks and dams. So up to this for today. So what you have learned, children, today? Today you have learned that the main sources of water is rain. Rain is the main source of water. And every living beings need water. Every living beings on this earth need water in order to live. And water comes from other sources also. What are the other sources of water? They are rivers, ponds, lakes, wells, hand pumps, etc. Hand pumps and wells, we get underground water from hand pumps and wells. And there are different way of storing water. At home we store water in bottles, in buckets, in other big pots, but a large amount of water is stored in water tanks that we can see on our ceilings when we in our houses. On the roof you might have seen, on the roof of your houses there is a water tank. In that, water comes from underground and it's stored there, and from there it's supplied to our taps, so that if there will be no water in the water tank, then we cannot get water in our water taps. So a large amount of water is stored in water tanks and dams. Dams are too much bigger. They have the much quantity of storing water, capacity of storing water. So children, we will revise up to this. Next day we will discuss about the next part of this chapter. Be safe. Enjoy yourself at home. Thank you.